Good lord, it's just been leaks galore for E3 2019. I mean, past E3s have had plenty of leaks too, but this year feels particularly fierce. I don't know if that's just me. So this year, among the leaks that occurred is for none other than the highly anticipated Cyberpunk 2077. It definitely looks like CD Projekt Red is making a huge marketing push this year. We're seeing giant billboards in front of the LA Convention Center. It just looks like they're ready to finally blow the lid wide open on this thing, which is why it's safe to say that we're probably going to see a new trailer, likely during Microsoft's press conference sometime tomorrow afternoon. Also, I mentioned before, but we're definitely gonna see new gameplay. CD Projekt Red has been inviting members of the media for a behind-closed-doors presentation that I'll be attending and reporting back on. As usual, I'll do a first impressions, followed by a play-by-play. I'll also be doing an interview with Mike Pondsmith and CD Projekt Red, so think of questions that you might want me to ask, and I'll put out like a poll or a post asking what you'd like me to ask and base my questions off of that, and this is down the line. Anyway, back to the leak at hand. It is nothing super major, but it's definitely pretty significant nonetheless. The following leak came from a Reset Era user who apparently has a friend who sent him the following image via Discord. At a glance, what we're looking at here is what seems to be the packaging for Cyberpunk 2077. And when I first looked at this, the first thought that came to mind was, okay, assuming this is real, this is most likely some kind of deluxe edition that you have to pay above $60 for. But then once word began to spread about this image, people looked at it and said that this may actually not be the case at all. Most people believe that what you're looking at here is actually the standard edition of Cyberpunk 2077. Yep, for $60, instead of just getting the game, you might get a bunch of other goodies alongside it, which is kind of unprecedented in this day and age when companies want to just milk you dry. But the thing about CD Projekt Red is that they already have a history of doing this in the past. A big part of why people believe this to be the standard edition is because if you go back and look at Witcher 3's marketing material leading up to the game's launch, you'll see that the standard edition package looked something like this. It looked very similar to what we're seeing in the so-called leaked image for Cyberpunk 2077. As you can see here, Witcher 3 Standard Edition came with a world map, various stickers, a game manual, a soundtrack CD, as well as a compendium of the Witcher universe. Pretty comprehensive stuff. And then if we go back to the Cyberpunk 2077 leaked image, showing what's speculated to be the Standard Edition, you can see that a lot of components are very similar. A lot of components parallel what we have seen before. So right here on the left, we've got a world map for Cyberpunk 2077. More specifically, this is a map of Night City, the setting of the game, and generally the setting of the Cyberpunk universe. And then if you look below that, there's this nice little postcard of Night City, which is this little extra souvenir that's quite neat. And then if you look towards the right on the bottom here, these are various stickers that will come with the package, also very much like The Witcher 3 Standard Edition, which came with stickers. And then above that, we have a compendium for the world of Cyberpunk 2077. Again, parallels Witcher 3, which came with its own compendium. Finally, up here, you can see a few other items listed. According to translators, it says right here that the package will also come with a mini art book, as well as a guidebook for Cyberpunk 2020, which is, of course, the tabletop RPG that is the source material that inspired Cyberpunk 2077. So all of this stuff comes standard for the base price you'd pay for a AAA game, so $60. Or at least that's the assumption. Again, this is all rumors and speculation for now. We're gonna get confirmation probably in the not-so-distant future, probably during Microsoft's press conference tomorrow. Now, even though this is a rumor, I would personally say, looking at this image, that there's a strong likelihood this is real. And assuming this is true, I think it's 90% assured that this is in fact the standard edition. I don't see CD Projekt Red deviating from that model. So yeah, we could be talking about a $60 package that other game companies might sell for $80 or $100 and label it Deluxe or Gold Deluxe, whatever the hell the nomenclature is these days. Assuming this is real, I would find it quite admirable that CD Projekt Red isn't lowering their standards. Like, they could get away with just selling the game at $60 without anything else. I think everyone would be happy with just that. But the possibility that they're not lowering that bar, that they're still holding true to their previous practices, That right there is something worth applauding. It just feels like CD Projekt Red is still once again going above and beyond, proving that they value customers, that their priority is consumer friendliness in a landscape where shady business practices is so commonplace among AAA titles. Whereas other publishers seem to be intent on milking your wallet dry the first chance they get, CD Projekt Red is the opposite. They always seem to be trying to add value to your buck, give you the best bang for your buck. And this comes on top of all the other consumer-friendly practices CD Projekt Red has committed to. So they've said time and again that microtransactions will not be present in any way, shape, or form for Cyberpunk 2077. More specifically, they said they're following the exact same model as Witcher 3, a model that was very well received by consumers and critics alike. In other words, huge single-player experience with no strings attached, with the design integrity kept intact, free bite-sized DLCs in the months following launch, and finally, large paid expansions akin to Blood and Wine, sold at a reasonable price with a boatload of content. Witcher 3 also had no DRM on PC, and CD Projekt Red has confirmed this will also carry through to Cyberpunk 2077. Most recently, the topic of Epic Store exclusivity has gained a lot of traction, a lot of heat, to which CD Projekt Red has already stated time and again that they're absolutely not signing any exclusivity deals whatsoever. They're giving that a hard pass. And now with them continuing this practice of giving people a standard edition that will give you more than what you asked for, yeah, I cannot help but love these guys even more. Other companies chip away things little by little. CD Projekt Red either maintains it or keeps adding, and man, that's just so unprecedented, and I feel like we need that very badly right now in this day and age. Now, assuming that Cyberpunk 2077 intends to follow Witcher 3's model to a T, I think it's also safe to expect that we're going to get some kind of collector's edition, because the way Witcher 3 did it was that they shipped two editions, the standard and the collector's. That's it. For those who were there for Witcher 3's launch, you may recall that that game's collector's edition had a bunch of stuff in the package. It featured a steel bookcase for the game, a 200-page hardcover art book, a Witcher medallion, which was pretty cool, and the creme de la creme, of course, is the awesome statue of Geralt slaying the griffin. This was all layered on top of the stuff that also came with the standard edition. Yes, it was a hefty $200, but at that price point, and given what you're being offered in that package, a lot of people found it reasonable. The hardcore fans were keen on getting their hands on this particular package. So once again, assuming CD Projekt Red is following Witcher 3 to a T, I would expect that Cyberpunk 2077's Collector's Edition will also cost no more than $200, and that it will feature very similar items. I think we're gonna get that steelbook case, some kind of hardcover art book, probably a few extra high-quality goodies like the Witcher Medallion layered on top, and the highlight of that package, like with Witcher 3, will probably be some kind of action figure, some kind of statue that will look really badass and high quality. And I do want to highlight the point that Witcher 3 only came with two editions, standard and collectors. Other companies will barrage you with all kinds of different editions that come with varying degrees of content, and it's just confusing for the consumer, which is exactly what they want. But CD Projekt Red is keeping it real, keeping it very simple, just one or the other, the lighter package or the more expensive package, and they outline very clearly what comes with each package, and the standard edition already comes with more than one might expect from a $60 game, while the collector's edition comes with some really coveted items for those hardcore fans. With all that said, I will remind you again that we should probably hold off until Microsoft's press conference, which is where I believe CD Projekt Red will confirm whether this is real or not, whether they're going to show a new trailer and probably unveil the packaging and all that stuff, possibly a release date. After all, this leak could very well turn out to be fake. I think that's a small chance, but it is possible. Or it could turn out that it is actually some kind of deluxe edition rather than the standard edition. I feel like that's also a very small possibility. I feel like CD Projekt Red isn't the kind of company to take a step backwards in terms of their practices. I'll also say that the fact that we're actually seeing rumors of potential package leaks for Cyberpunk 2077 tells us that a release date, or a release window at least, a reveal for that information is very likely. A lot of companies tend to announce their release date when they feel like they've finalized the packaging, the different editions, as well as when they feel like they're ready to start taking pre-orders. And I believe that after Microsoft's press conference, the doors will open for pre-orders for both Standard and Collector's Edition. And yeah, assuming that these packages remain as friendly as we saw them back in Witcher 3, I would more than happily purchase the Collector's Edition. We'll have to wait and see what it actually comes with, what the statue is going to be. That's going to be a big point for a lot of people who might be willing to shell out $200 for a game and its various items. And we're probably going to find out very soon. So yeah, a lot of excitement in the air surrounding this game. I cannot wait to see the new gameplay. I cannot wait to see how much the game has changed and evolved over the past year. So yeah, there you have it, folks. That's all I have to say on what looks to be a pretty legitimate leak of what could very well be Cyberpunk 2077 Standard Edition. I'd love to hear what your take is on all of this in the comments below. With that, I would like to end this news update and discussion video. Thank you for tuning in. To be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.